We just learned what machine learning is, and we introduced a simple example of building a bird classifier. Now, the big question is, how does machine learning relate to deep learning? If we consider the whole field of machine learning, we can think of deep learning as a subfield of machine learning, where we use deep neural networks or neural networks with many layers. And there's another term you might have heard of, artificial intelligence, or in short, AI. So how is AI now related to machine learning and deep learning? Historically, everything started with this big field of AI, a subfield of computer science, where researchers try to make computers smarter, or developing, let's say, smart robots and computers for complex problem solving. Machine learning was then born as a subfield of AI to give computers the ability to learn from data. So there are different ways we can make systems and computers intelligent. One way is, for example, by hand coding complex rules. So as a programmer, we can come up with our own rules, or like if and else statements, to make machines smarter. However, this can be a lot of work, and machine learning is this paradigm where we help computers automatically learn from data. Coming back to the question of deep learning versus machine learning, though, you might wonder if both are related to each other and both are ways we can teach computers to learn from data, when do we actually use deep learning versus regular machine learning? So here's an example we saw in the last video. We have 6 pictures of birds, and we can think of this as an unstructured data set. And in contrast, there's something called structured data that essentially looks like a data set table. So here each row represents one of the birds. And then in the columns, we have different measurements of the birds. Someone actually took some measurements of these birds to come up with these features. And often this requires domain knowledge, knowing what is important in a data set. So for example here, someone measured the beak length of the birds or the wingspan and wrote down the color of the different birds. And both are different ways we can input data to a machine learning system. On the left-hand side, this unstructured data set is something deep learning is particularly good at. So deep learning, it's also why it's sometimes called representation learning, can make sense of more raw or unstructured forms of data. However, if we have a data set where we already have extracted feature information, such as here on the right-hand side, that's usually a use case for regular or conventional machine learning. So now that we learned what machine learning is and how machine learning is related to deep learning, let's take a look at some of the common use cases of machine learning in the next video.